boots.
All of your homes. All of your finances.
And all your ass
boots. All of your health.
It's time to go. God spoke to a donkey. God spoke to a donkey. No matter who you are, no matter what you mean, you're going to go to God, because God has called you. God has called you. We've all heard the story of Abraham and donkey. Ever since we were little children. But this is an unusual story for a number of reasons, not the least of which is the talking donkey. So what I want you to do this afternoon is introduce the major players in this drama as we see that the stations God has applied for us, and may we have what He made for us today. So first, let's start with the donkey. I realized I didn't really know that much about donkeys when I first read the text. So I did a little research on the internet. One sermon I read on the net noted that in the Bible, 10 times donkey was all-purpose. In Bible times, donkey were all-purpose vehicles like ATVs. And they were used for transportation, carrying loads, girding grain, and plowing fields. They were kind of a pickup truck for a farmer. They were highly dependable, very gentle, and extremely friendly to people. In fact, the only major drawback to donkeys is their supposed mule headedness. Most of the sources I've read noted that the infamous donkey stubbornness keeps these animals and their riders out of danger. When a donkey senses danger, they simply tend to freeze. They refuse to move. So the reaction of Balaam's donkey had to the angel of God was natural. Next, I did research on what the Bible says about donkeys, and I was surprised at what I discovered. I found, for an example, that they are very often part of major Bible stories. Abraham saddled his donkey to take Isaac to be sacrificed, Genesis 22. Joseph's brother took donkeys with them to get food from Egypt, Genesis 42. Moses saddled his donkeys to go on the trip to Egypt to free Israel, Ezekiel 4:20. And of course, Jesus rode a donkey into Jerusalem a week before he was crucified in order to fulfill the prophecy that he would do so, Matthew 21:5 and Zechariah 9:9. And I also found that donkeys were very important animals in the scripture. In fact, they are so important that their firstborn offspring was the only unclean animal that God's law required to be redeemed by sacrifice of the lamb, Ezekiel 13:13. The law required that a man's donkey had to rest on the Sabbath day, Exodus 23:12. If it was stolen, the thief was required to pay back twice the donkey's value, Exodus 22:4. Exodus 23:5 simply commanded that if you see a donkey of someone who hates you falling down under its load, do not leave it there, but be sure to help him with it. And the donkey was one of the only two animals mentioned in the Ten Commandments. So donkeys were highly valuable in God's people and to God Himself. So that's the donkey. Now let's turn our attention to the Midianites and one of their kings, a man named Balak. Balak was a troubled king. One day he wakes up and finds a whole herd of Israelite people marching through his land. That doesn't make him happy. He's afraid they'll eat up everything in sight and leave the land desolate. So he considers fighting them, but he's smart enough to know that ain't really going to get him nowhere tonight. That he can't fight these trespassers on his own, so he sends messengers to a famous prophet who is said to have been connected to God.